This has got to be one of the ugliest planes in all of War Thunder. This is the Sea Vixen, a rank 5 British premium jet that doesn't even have an internal gun. And yes, that is just about as fun as it sounds. And it sounds not very fun. That's because it isn't. But there's two things that this thing's really good at. Number one, it's really good at ruining other people's fun. And number two, it gets an extremely large amount of Silver Lions per game. It's got the highest multiplier and the highest percentage possible for a plane in air realistic battles, which is 1140% Silver Lions on a 3.8 times 2 multiplier. Those are, of course, the numbers with a premium account, so you do get the 100% and 50% bonuses, but even without premium, you know, you take away premium and you look at the stat cards, it's still going to be the highest that you can get on a plane. And you are seeing that, right? I am getting 18,000 Silver Lions per aircraft kill, and this is with no boosters activated whatsoever. It's just the premium account, and the Sea Vixen is getting me 18,000 SL per kill. So let's talk about the Sea Vixen a little bit here. Well, for the rest of the video, honestly. As I mentioned in the beginning, it does not have a gun. It does have 4 red top missiles, which are honestly just kind of trolly. They're really rat-like. The whole Sea Vixen itself is a very rat-like plane because you have to play it like a rat. You have to stay really fast, which you're faster than pretty much everything at the battle rating. At least 8.7, a lot of 9.0s, most 9.0s for that matter, and even some 9.3s you are faster than. So you just fly away from everything and don't let them get within gun range, and then once they're bored or have somebody else coming up on their 6 and they have to turn around and turn away from you, then you slot in behind them and you launch a red top at them. And the red top is a 16G infrared missile. So it's a heat seeker that can pull 16 Gs, which doesn't sound like a lot if you're used to top tier jets, but 16 Gs at 8.7 battle rating is pretty difficult to outpool unless you have a lot of speed. So what you end up getting is a plane that actually has 4 very capable weapons, and it's just a really annoying plane to actually use to be able to deploy those weapons. As I said, you're just going to be running away from people, zooming in and out of the battle, and basically third-partying people with missiles that they more than likely won't be able to dodge by the time you actually shoot at them. Like I said, they have to be going considerably fast to actually be able to dodge them. For example, this B-57, even if he sees that red top coming, he's just too slow. There was no chance in hell he was getting away from that. I guess you could say that even for an AIM-9B, but this is an uncaged seeker, so I can kind of lead the missile and help myself. You're going to see right here even that the AIM-9B is, of course, pretty simple to outpool, whereas the red top is going to actually require a good amount of effort and a good amount of speed, and a lot of times 8.7 planes, 9.0 planes, and of course anything below is going to have a really hard time both putting in the effort and having the speed to be able to put in that effort. And so just again, you basically get a plane that denies people from being able to play the game because they have to be paying attention and not only pay attention, but react to you at all times. If you see a Sea Vixen coming behind you and it's something like a MiG-15 Bis, you're going to have to turn and make sure that he doesn't get your 6, because if he has your 6, then he can launch a missile. And so it's just really annoying to have to deal with. You have to give up on whatever you're fighting and then deal with the Sea Vixen without actually dealing with the Sea Vixen. I could rant about this plane forever. I just really wish it wasn't in the game, but here it is. Granted, the red tops do have some pretty short range, especially so after the missile drag change. All the missiles have more drag, especially so once the motor is burned out and it's just kind of gliding through the air. Red tops are exceptionally poor when it comes to drag. These things are chunky, they've got really big fins, and they kind of just have less range than even an AIM-9B. I wouldn't recommend launching these things outside of 1.5 kilometers on subsonic targets. Even that is pushing it. It just depends on your altitude and speed. And I certainly wouldn't recommend launching them over even just like 1.1 kilometers on a supersonic target that you have the 6 o'clock of. And of course, ranges of your missile is going to always depend on how fast you're going, how fast your target is going, and the altitude and aspect you launch the missile at. So these are just rough estimates, keep in mind. Sometimes you'll be able to launch them from further away, and sometimes that might even be too far away, as short as it seems. But regardless, the red top's performance outside of range is actually pretty dang good. Defensively, there's really not a whole lot you can do to defend yourself other than simply run away. And as I said earlier, this plane is very fast for an 8.7. There's pretty much nothing at 8.7 that can catch you. There's very few things at 9.0 that can catch you. and even a lot of 9-3s are going to struggle to keep up. And so basically you just have to run away from every fight that is brought to your front door and hope that you still have some teammates around. This plane can be pretty damn strong with teammates around, but if you don't have teammates around, there's really nothing you can do to actually do any damage to the other team, because once they get on your 6, they're not going to get off. They have no reason to turn around or to leave your 6, and therefore you're never going to be able to actually launch your missiles at them. Sure, you could try to energy trap them and stall them out sort of so that you can stall back on top of them and shoot a missile at them on the way down, but that's just going to require the enemy to not know what they're doing, and I wouldn't really call that a viable strategy. It's going to take a little bit of luck on both ends. So the missiles are very strong for the battle rating. The flight performance is enough to get you by, because at the very least it can go really fast, but not having a gun means you're pretty much at the mercy of your team. If your team's not doing well, you're gonna have a really hard time picking up kills in this thing. However, you can still have a pretty decent early game impact with this thing. As far as the missiles go, you can get them off really quickly. In fact, I recommend only ever taking min fuel, because you're gonna get these missiles off pretty quick, and there's just no need to carry any more than min fuel. 7 minutes. If you don't have all 4 missiles off by the time you're running out of gas, you're probably not being aggressive enough, and so you can take this thing pretty early game and pick off a lot of targets pretty rapidly by having 4 16G missiles at 8.7. And while this is going to help turn the tide in your favor, it still, again, is ultimately up to your teammates to try to pull through and finish up the rest of the game, because by the time you land and try to get some more missiles, the game's going to be pretty much decided at that point. You're either going to be going to go fly into your death the time you take off the airfield, or you're going to be going in and cleaning up the last couple of enemies because your teammates have done the job and won the game already. As far as picking out targets goes, that's up to you. I would say that if you're just going purely for Silver Lions, then find the 4 closest bombing berries that you can find that don't have countermeasures, that are just going straight for your bases. Usually they're easy enough to just slot in behind and put a missile right up the ass of before they can actually do anything or react to you. That's always a quick and easy way to get some SL at this thing. But if you want to make sure you're winning more games, I would definitely focus down some more important fighters. Yeah, you might not always get as many consistent red top kills as you would with somebody that's just AFKing straight for a base, but you will have a greater impact, as much as you can anyways, as far as who wins the match. And of course, winning a match gives you more SL in the end. Of course, avoid launching these things at anything with flares or countermeasures, because the red top is going to eat those flares up every single time. They're not flare resistant in the slightest, so definitely pick out targets that don't have flares. Stay away from the A4s, and honestly, that might be about it. The Q5, maybe the A5C. No, you can't even see the A5C. So yeah, very few of your targets are going to have flares, but those that do, it's just generally not even worth shooting a missile at. And I forgot to mention that this thing does have a radar too. Not that the radar is super useful. You can slave your missiles to the radar, meaning that it basically just points the seeker to whatever the radar is locked onto, and therefore you don't have to actually manually fly your nose over the target and point the missile seeker at it. And that kind of helps for off-boresight shots to give the missile a little bit of extra lead, or if you're trying to get a head-on lock last second and you want to point your nose away from the target so that you don't ram them, but you still want to try a head-on, something like that. These missiles do have very limited all-aspect capability. A hot target with an afterburner, you can actually shoot in a head-on at very close range. Suicidal range, honestly, because they will probably start shooting at you by the time you get a lock-in, but anything slightly off of a head-on, a slight 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock angle, of course, even, and the red top can lock pretty damn reliably, despite being a rear aspect missile. Overall, I think that the Sea Vixen is a pretty decent pickup for somebody that just wants an SL grinder. I wouldn't necessarily recommend this plane if you want to grind the British tree, because it is only a rank 5 premium, and therefore it only researches vehicles rank 1 through 6 with the premium research bonus. So after rank 6, this thing's not going to help you too much as far as grinding goes. But for somebody that just wants an SL printer, as I said, this thing's actually pretty dang strong and pretty reliable. Of course, for newer players too, missiles are a lot easier to get into than something with guns. The F5C, for example, is a fantastic plane, but at 10.3 with only 10G missiles, a lot of newer players are going to actually struggle to learn how to play that thing, whereas missile combat obviously just kind of holds your hand. And having 16G missiles at 8.7 is going to actually be pretty easy for just about anybody to get kills with. That pretty much does it for my summary of the Sea Vixen. If that's all you wanted to hear, feel free to click off of this video right now. But for this last clip, I am going to actually analyze a little bit of gameplay. So if you want help playing it, or if you want to see what I'm thinking when I'm playing this thing, well, here we go. I usually start off at high altitude like you see right now because, one, this thing outclimbs a lot of the jets of the BR just because of how fast it is. It's got great engine. And of course, if you're coming from straight above people, usually they're not going to be looking directly above them. And sometimes it just helps sneak up on people and lob a missile at them without them actually really noticing. So I've hit a G91. I'm not going to be able to do anything head-on against these guys. I see a lot of Sea Vixen players stick head-ons. Maybe it's because they're trying to get that last-second all-aspect shot, but it's usually not going to work, so I don't know why people stick head-on so often. You just really shouldn't. We simply outpull the M9B, even though we were climbing and getting a little bit slow. All we got to do is hold the elevator down. Something a red top would definitely have hit right there. The G91 is kind of stalled out. I'm not sure if this is the same one that I had already crit. Regardless, we're going to go ahead and finish that guy off. And now I'm just going to be running away from the A5 Sabre. Anytime you've got somebody on your 6 as a Sea Vixen, and you pretty much can just run. That's about all you can do. So I'm going to run away from this guy, bring him back down to the deck, and then once he's back down on the deck, I'm going to start climbing away from him because this thing's definitely going to be out climbing an A5 Sabre all day long. Once I've got enough separation from him, from either my climb or just being faster, then I'm going to turn myself back around and see if I can get another red top off on somebody. I do have an SU-7, which is ultimately going to force the F-86 to turn around, as well as the other teammates down there, and so I know I'm free to turn around here. And, well, so I think, it's funny enough, he ends up just gunning it for me anyways. I'm still fast enough, though. I'm not really worried about him. He's going to throw some shots down at me. There are 50 cals, but still, he's over a kilometer away. And now I'm just looking at who my next target should be. I'm coming from above and behind the F-86, but I believe he's going after the teammates that were following that A-5. And so now I'm just left with this FJ-4, who is definitely slow enough to be eating a red top. And that's the thing. You're going to be picking out targets that are slow when possible, because if you're going slow, there's absolutely no dodging the red top. And this is especially true with the red top. You know, something like an AIM-9B, you still might be able to outpull at, say, 600 kilometers an hour. That's pretty dang slow, but with an AIM-9B, it might be possible. The red top, you're just dead. And so I'm just going to pull around on this last F-86, get my last red top off, and score my last kill. You pretty much just saw me running away from anybody that had their nose pointed at me, and then I come back around when I have their 6 o'clock. That's pretty much just how you play the Sea Vixen, and that's also just why it's not very capable of actually carrying any matches on its own. So there you have it, that's the Sea Vixen. I've got another upload possibly coming as soon as Sunday, but if not, expect it later in the week. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you later.